Bosch microchips and sensors are used all over the car. For example, in electronic control units and safety systems like an airbag or ESP. As vehicles continue to become smarter and smarter, the importance of semiconductors will continue to grow.
I'm here in Silicon Saxony, which is one of the three largest semiconductor clusters in the world. This here is in Dresden, and I get to find out exactly how a semiconductor is made in a clean room.
Hi, Nicole.
I found you.
Perfect, perfect. Nice to have you here in Dresden.
Yeah, very cool.
Yeah, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it's not only intended for indoor navigation, of course. We are using that in the entire building. So the entire infrastructure here is building up in the building information modeling. That means we have a digital twin or a virtual 3D model behind.
So you can actually try things out digitally before you implement them in the real world.
Correctly. That's the idea behind. Saving time, saving money, and avoiding impact for the production.
So it seems like a really cool toy, but there's gotta be a lot of computing power behind this.
Correct, there's a lot of computing behind. We have a very comprehensive IT system with lots of servers, hardware, and software behind. As a result, we can run our production by a computer-controlled manufacturing system completely automated. The applications are communicating with each other and they're taking automated decisions for our production.
So this works pretty seamlessly. How exactly are all these computers talking to each other?
Just we have already installed partially the 5G infrastructure, which would allow us to exchange even more data, tons of data, in a much quicker way. So we could connect terminal devices and mobile devices much faster.
So I'm pretty excited to get to the clean room because I got to visit your facility in Reutlingen. And I know you guys have something cool to show me here. So will this take me to the clean room or will you?
We both would bring you there, but I would be delighted to go with you. Let's go.
Awesome. So now that I'm all suited up, yeah. Where to next?
So before we reach the clean room, we have to pass the air shower because we have to remove all the remaining particles of your suit. Because we have to get rid of all the particles to avoid that they get on our wafers and spoil our wafers.
So this whole getup wasn't enough?
That wasn't enough, no.
So this is it, this is the clean room.
Exactly, we're in now, yeah.
And it's very yellow.
Yeah, it's yellow because our wafers and our material is very light sensitive. So this is the smart factory, which is fully automated. We have most advanced factory control system. All the wafers are handled automatically, as
wow.
You can see on our transport system.
There goes
system.
One there.
Exactly.
And so this is where the digital twin would come in as well.
Yeah, in the future, the digital twin will help us that the data we are generating together with artificial intelligence and self-optimized algorithms that we can improve and that the machine can learn by itself and can optimize the processes.
That's so cool.
The basic material for our microchips is silicon. We start our production process with thin slices of silicon, the so-called wafers. The integrated circuits are deposited in layers on our 300 millimeter wafers through a sequence of chemical and physical process steps. The production process comprises hundreds of different production steps, then build up finally the microscopic structures of the microelectronics on the wafer.
Look at this, look at this. What do you want me doing with this? It's beautiful. So exactly how many chips are on here?
Well, there are hundreds of chips on this wafer leaving our factory.
And so this actually powers our cars and devices built in a factory.
Exactly.
Controlled with artificial intelligence.
Exactly, but still also with smart people, because only by combining them together, intelligence of machinery and of smart people, we can get products like this.
Amazing.
Yeah, Bosch is always investing strategically at long-term sustainable digitalization. And for sure, technology that we have here in Dresden is one major part of, for the mobility of the future.
So AI is really everywhere here.
Correct, we have it everywhere. We use it to improve the quality of our chips. We make the cars smarter with that by enlarging the distances. You can be ensured in the future, driving is getting more and more comfortable, safer and stressless.
I can't wait for this future. I hope it happens today. Well, thanks so much for having me. I especially loved the clean room. Now I know where the chips for the car of the future are made. Off to our common future.